Hello, today I will show you how to draw a typical filming pan and major. First of all, you need to understand there's a common formula. It's a very simple one, and you can use just few seconds. You can estimate the size of the beams. And for example, for the cantilever, we just divided the span divided by 7. You can estimate the size, and the semi support is divided by 20, and continuous beam divided by 26. Actually, you need to know what is cantilever. Most likely the cantilever will be projected from the columns without the end support, and the simply supported beam is something like the only one beam alone, we call simply supported. And if two beams can continuous, that means one node and the second one, the steel reinforcement can be continuous, we call continuous beam. You can see the section, the beam actually, the reinforcement can go through, and then we call this is a continuous beam. And then for this simple formula, you can estimate the depth of the continuous beam. For example, it's span divided by 26 for continuous. For semi support is 20, and cantilever is 7. But you need to understand this is just an estimation of the depth of the beam. After you calculate the result, you need to allow some contingencies. That means, for example, you calculate it's a 300. Normally, you say 500 is the estimate size, because this is a roughly a estimation of the value. That means this is not exact figure. This is a simple step to draw a filming pan. First of all, you need to understand mostly the main beam is connect columns to columns, and then outside the secondary beams, then outside slab, use the span tab ratio to estimate the main beam size, secondary beam size, and the size of slab, and draw a typical section. First of all, this is one of the example. For example, this is a column with a 7.5 meter center to center. And then the first one, you need to understand the first step is connect, just connect beams between columns. We call this is a main beam, because this take the window that we lost normally, we call this is main beam. The second step, you assign the secondary beam. Normally for the secondary beams in Hong Kong or reinforced concrete, 2.5 to 3 meter center to center is an optimum size, and the reinforcement is much more economical. That means for 7.5 meter divided by 2.5, at least 3 interval. That means assign 2 numbers of beams. And then the third step is assign the slab. Normally you can see this is, we call this is a one-way slab. The loading transfer from the left to the right. This is the arrow showing where's the loading going. And now we try to estimate the size, use the span depth ratio. For example, we try the main beam first. This is a so-called the continuous I talked to you before. And then use the formula span divided by 26. And this is, remember, span is the distance between center line of column to column, we call span. This is some of the result. And what I'm saying before, you need to allow some in contingency. That means, if for example, your result is 288, try to assume it's 400 depth of this beam. For the width, normally, you can say this is a 500, okay? Because normally the width, the architect will not be care too much. We only normally care about the depth, because you can imagine the headroom is directly affected by the depth of the beam. We do the same for the secondary beams. They are the same spans, and we assume the width of the secondary beam can be smaller, because you can imagine the loading should be smaller than the main beam. Okay, main beam take the window also. That means they need to have a larger size. And then the third one, for the reinforced concrete, normally you can say this is 150. In the world, I can see most of the size is 150. That means try to say this is 150 is good enough. And then go to the last step is draw a section. For example, this is a section AA. After you estimate the size, you dip before, you can see the depth is 400 and 500 width, and 300 for the secondary beam. This is a section AA. Okay, and then you can finish the very typical framing pen. That means wherever you take out the framing pens, try to use this principle. You can easily estimate the size and then can further discuss with the engineers whether they can fulfill the size, and then they will tell you the results. Okay, thank you.